So hello everyone, today we are going to discuss a new topic, that is generalized uncertainty principle. Before that, we are going to discuss that what Heisenberg uncertainty principle state. So it states that for any body, both position and momentum of any body cannot be measured more accurately at the same instant of time. Okay, so this is given as del x, that is the position representation, and momentum representation, that is del p, which is greater than equals to h cut by 2. Okay, this is Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Okay, now moving towards generalized uncertainty principle, let us take two Hermitian operators, that is a and b. We are taking Hermitian operators here because Hermitian operators have real eigenvalues, which are found to be more accurate when they are calculated experimentally. Okay, so a and b are the Hermitian operators. So so let's define a function, that is del a equals to, that is expectation value of a equals to a minus some expectation value of a. Okay, similarly for b, this can be followed. The expectation value with respect to state vectors can be represented as expectation value of VA. This can be written for state vectors is like that k of psi unit vector A, and hence this is the bra of psi. Okay, divided by this normalized condition for state vectors. Similarly taken for B, represented here. Now to take a standard deviation, we have to square this average expectation value. So let us take this value from equation 1. Let us consider it as equation 1. So from this equation 1, we have to take a standard deviation value. So you are going to square this 4 term. So finally we get del a square equals to whole bracket of this expectation value term. Similarly followed for b vector also. Now from this expectation value of a and expectation value of b, we have to determine for standard deviation. So we have to square these values. Now further for better simplification, this bracket square can be simplified as a square minus twice of a expectation value of a plus square of expectation value. Similarly for b, it can be written as del b square, means expectation value of b square equals to b square minus 2b into expectation value of b plus expectation value of b whole square. Okay, so this value we have to substitute in standard state form, state vector. This equation can be extended as this type. Okay, so here we done only one thing, that we substitute the value of del a, means expectation value of a. Okay, so further after solving, we observe that this term will be cancelled out. Okay, means this psi term and this psi term will cancel out with this psi term. Okay, so we have entered in next step, that is del a square minus twice of a expectation value of a plus expectation value square. Okay, this can be written as expectation value square square of a expectation value minus of expectation value of a square. Okay, this is the expectation value we have calculated. Okay, so now let us this expectation value as sigma. So this sigma and expectation value further can be written as sigma square a equals to expectation value of a, which is equals to this term. Okay, so similarly we call this equation number 2. And similarly for calculating after for b Hermitian operator, we get this value. Okay, so the value for Hermitian operator a and Hermitian operator b in terms of expectation value is obtained as this equation number 2 and 3. Okay,
so hello, my name is Venkatesh Tiwari and I am going to continue the further part of the derivation which was further before explained by Vivek. So up to before we have come to know the value of sigma a and then sigma b. Now further, as you can see, the formula that is from Cauchy-Schwarz inequality, This is the well-known inequality which you all might be knowing, that is expectation value of del A square into expectation value of del B square is greater than or equal to, actually this is not square, sorry for that, expectation value of del A into expectation value of del B is greater than or equal to the modulus of expectation value of del A into del B whole square. Now we are going to take the RHS of this formula, that is this inequality I am writing here, and we are going to manipulate some parts of it. I will tell you how. First of all, we are writing this in this form, that is this is equal to half of expectation value of commutation of del A with del B plus half of expectation value of anti-commutation of del A with del B. This is the fourth equation I am giving. Now, actually this can be verified. Why I am writing this? I can verify also by using the commutation and anti-commutation relation. I can verify that this is equal to this. So that's why I am writing that. Now further, I am going to take this part, that is the first part of RHS. I am writing here, that is commutation of del A with del B, that is equal to del A, we know that it is A minus expectation value of A, del B is equal to B minus expectation value of B. This we have seen in the before slides. Now, I am ignoring or neglecting this expectation value of A and expectation value of B. Why? Because these are the commutating terms with the operators, hence we can ignore them, because this would be some constant value and that can be ignored because we are just taking the non-commutating terms in the further parts. So this part is equal to commutation of A with B. Now this we are going to replace in equation 4, this equation. So this equation 4 becomes somewhat like this, that is expectation value of del A with del B is equal to half of, I replace this and this part is written as it is, as the before equation. Now this part and this part, if you look clearly or closely, you can observe that this is the anti-Hermitian operator, whereas this is the Hermitian operator, that is the commutation of A with B is the anti-Hermitian, whereas anti-commutation of A del A with del B is Hermitian operator. Now this would lead to somewhat problem of imaginary parts. So to overcome that, what we are going to do, you can see further that I am squaring, I am taking a mod and squaring on both the sides of this equation, as you can see. So I just took the mod and squared this side, LHS, RHS also I am doing the same. Now when I square this side, it would lead to a formula of A plus B whole square. So I didn't write that, I am writing in short, I am directly expanding the A plus B whole square here. So if I write this, it would become somewhat like this, that is first term square, that is 1 by 4 and square of this plus 1 by 4 square of this. Now here there should be one more term, that is plus 2ab. I have not written that. Why I have not written that? Because if I write 2ab, what would be 2ab? 2 into a. A would be commutation of A with B. B would be anti-commutation of del A with del B. Now those two terms would cancel each other and that would lead to 0. So plus 0. So I am not writing that. Now this term, as you can see, it is del of A and del of B, and already they are very small terms. Now again, if you take square of those terms, it would become even smaller. So there is no need to write this. You can neglect it as compared to the first part. So you can neglect this term in compared to this. So neglecting this and further writing the equation, it would be mod of del A into del B is equal to 1 by 4 square of mod of expectation value of commutation of A with B whole square. So up to this, the equation shortens to this equation. So from the Cauchy inequality, we know a formula which is somewhat like this, Now, proceeding further, substituting the value of this term, that is, we concluded that mod of expectation value of del A del B whole square is 1 by 4 mod of expectation value of commutation of A with B whole square. So substituting this in place of this, we would be getting this term. Now squaring on both the sides. Now if I square on both the sides, it is very simple, we will be getting this term, that is expectation value of del A into expectation value of del B is greater than or equal to 1 by 2 mod of expectation value of commutation of A with B. This is the final equation, that is the generalized uncertainty principle. Why I am saying that it is generalized? Because here in place of del A and del B, we can check the uncertainty of position and momentum, or we can check the uncertainty in energy and time. So this is the generalized. Suppose if I, for example, take position and momentum here in place of A and B, I am taking so and putting in place of in this formula, we will be getting so and so. Now removing the expectation sign, just taking the their proper values, this would be the formula, which is the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. So likewise, we can conclude the same equation or the same uncertainty for energy and time. So that is why this is called the generalized uncertainty principle. So this was our topic. Hope you understood. So thanks a lot. Thank you very much.